So good afternoon to one and all. So myself, Sridhar Babu, so associate professor from EEE department. So today we are going to discuss about some topics in power system operation and control. Power system operation and control. Firstly, here, what is the objective of power system operation and control? So here, the objective is minimization of cost. The main objective of the power system operation and control is minimization of cost, right? So and in order to achieve this objective, so we need to allocate the load. We need to allocate the load among the units. Right. So if I allocate the load among the units in such a way that we will get the reduction in the cost, then we can achieve the objective of the power system operation and control, right? And one more important topic we are going to discuss is input output characteristics. Here, so in order to understand this input output characteristics, so we have to plot the graph. So that is between the fuel input to the system versus the output. Fuel input. Here the units are million BTU per hour. Next, here the other one is that is x-axis. We have the power output. Power output in megawatt. The curve will be like this. So P. That is minimum power and this is maximum power. So this is nothing but your input output characteristics. So here input is the fuel input to the system. Here the system which consisting of the N units. So units means it's a combination of a generator and a turbine, right? So like this, the system is consisting of N number of units, right? Here the characteristics will be like fuel input, that is in terms of million BTU. Here BTU stands for British Thermal Units. British Thermal Units. Right. So output power. So units will be in megawatts. Right. And one more thing is here we are going to consider thermal plant or steam plant. We are going to consider the system is consisting of thermal plants. It means for thermal plant, the input will be coal, that is the fuel input is coal. So anyway, output will be power. So that's why here the units, I will make it as a BTU, that is British Thermal Units, which is the unit for fuel input. Right. From this input output characteristics, here we have some definitions which are very, very important. The first one is heat rate curve. So what is heat rate curve? Here a heat rate curve, the definition is comes from this characteristics. It is the ratio of fuel input to the corresponding power output. So that is the definition of heat rate curve. Heat rate curve is, again we need to plot this characteristic, that is input output characteristics, which consisting of input is fuel input, that is in terms of million BTU per hour, and output power will be in megawatts. Again we need to plot the curve. Now the definition is like this. It is the ratio of fuel input to the corresponding power output. Now the Now I am, what do you call, I am writing like this, F by P. Where F is fuel input, P is power output. Now the units will be million BTU per hour. That is the fuel input units, that is F units, that is million BTU per hour. Next, power units will be megawatt. So finally, the units for heat rate curve is million BTU per megawatt hour. So these are the units for heat rate curve. Again, I will, the definition is, it is a ratio of fuel input to the corresponding power output, that is F by P. Now the units are million BTU per megawatt hour. Next, coming to the second definition, which is incremental fuel rate. Incremental, second one is incremental fuel rate. Second definition is incremental fuel rate. That is IFR. Incremental fuel rate, which is also comes from this input-output characteristics, right? So incremental, so it means it changes. If you want to generate more output power, we need to change the input. So that's, now the definition is, it is defined as a small change in the fuel input to the corresponding changes occurred in the output. That is, I can write it as a small change in fuel input to the corresponding changes occurred in the output power. A small change in output. Right. So this one will be written as, here incremental, that if the term comes, we need to indicate either D or delta. First I will write it with D, that is df by dv. So df means changes in fuel input to the changes in the power output, or delta f by delta p. Both will be same. In some textbooks, some authors will follow df by dp, some authors will follow delta f by delta. Both will be same. Here d or delta indicates changes. That is incremental, right? So now the definition is, it is defined as the ratio of small change in the fuel input to the corresponding changes occurred in the power output. So that is df by dp or delta f by delta p. Now the units will be same. Million, what are the units for the heat rate curve? The same units. Million BTU per megawatt hour. This is the second definition, that is heat rate curve. Next, one more definition is there, that is third one, that is incremental fuel cost. All these definitions are coming from these characteristics, that is input-output characteristics of that particular plant. Here we are going to consider thermal plant. Third one is incremental fuel cost. Incremental fuel cost. Now the definition is, it is the product of incremental fuel rate. It is a product of incremental fuel rate and the cost of the fuel. And the cost of fuel, especially in thermal plants, the fuel is coal, right? So the cost of fuel for this, especially for this thermal plant or steam plants, that will be in rupees per BTU. The cost of fuel units, rupees per BTU. As already we know the units for this incremental fuel, that is million BTU or BTU per megawatt hour, so will be the unit for
incremental fuel rate, it should be multiplied by cost of the fuel. Units will be rupees per BTU.
Rupees per BTU. Now these two will cancel.
So finally, the units for incremental fuel cost is rupees per megawatt hour. That is the unit for incremental fuel cost. The definition is, it is a product of incremental fuel rate and the cost of fuel in rupees per BTU. Or incremental fuel rate is multiplied by the cost of fuel in rupees per BTU. So for this, units will be rupees per megawatt hour. So that one will be the third definition, that is incremental fuel cost. Next, fourth one, that is incremental production cost. Incremental production cost. Incremental production cost. Incremental production cost. Right. So here's the definition. So incremental production cost, which consisting of incremental fuel cost, that is IFC, incremental fuel cost plus the cost of, here we need to consider the salaries of the employees. Next, maintenance we need to consider, and the supply system, and water, etc. All these together we are going to call as incremental production cost. Especially here we are going to call either incremental production cost or incremental fuel cost, both will be same. Next, the fifth one, that is the last definition from these characteristics, that is incremental efficiency. Incremental efficiency. Right. So we know the definition of efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but the ratio of output power to the input power. Here also, incremental means we need to consider that either delta or beta. Right. Efficiency, output by input. Especially for this thermal plant, we have the input as fuel input, that is, that will be represented by F. Output power is, output is going to be represented by P. So therefore, incremental efficiency is output. What is output? P. Input is F. That is the efficiency. Incremental efficiency means either we need to consider D or delta. D by dP by dF or delta P by delta F. Both will be same. dP by dF or delta P by delta F. It means a small change of, I can say its a definition is the ratio of a small change in the power output to the corresponding changes in fuel input, that is F. That is dP by dF or delta P by delta F. Isn't it? So these are the definitions which are going to comes from this input-output characteristics. The first one is heat rate curve, next incremental fuel rate, next incremental fuel cost, next incremental production cost, and finally we have incremental efficiency. All these definitions from heat rate curve to incremental efficiency are coming from this input-output characteristics. Here input-output characteristics is nothing but fuel input versus power output, right? So this is about the input-output characteristics. So next, here we have one small topic, that is optimal generation allocation or optimal generation allocation, or I can say it is also called as economic load dispatch. Economic load dispatch. Here optimum generation allocation is nothing but with this the load should be allocated among the units with minimum cost. So that is the definition of optimum generation allocation. So with this, I am ending.